Oi, pessoal. Nós estamos numa série de vídeos sobre o desafio do amor próprio, da autoestima. E para o vídeo de hoje, eu tenho um convidado especial. Eu fiz uma pequena entrevista com o meu querido amigo Patrick Ziegler. Para quem não conhece, o Patrick é um professor espiritual incrível e ele tem um trabalho maravilhoso chamado All Love. Nesse trabalho do All Love, ele nos ensina como de fato nos conectarmos com o nosso coração e com essa energia do amor, que é uma energia cósmica e que, por ser cósmica, está em nós também. Sem tempo, sem distância, no todo e no ínfimo, infinito, bem perto, escrito no seu destino, independente de condições, pessoas, caminho ou momento, aqui e agora, em cada batida do seu coração, o seu estado natural é ser felicidade. Eu conversei um pouquinho com o Patrick sobre o amor em nós, o amor próprio e como a gente encontra esse amor em nós. Eu peço que você coloque sua atenção na parte da entrevista em que o Patrick diz que aquilo que a gente imagina que o outro desperta em nós, na verdade, já está no nosso coração. Esse é o amor que existe em você. Hey, Patrick. Welcome. Thank you for being part of my channel and thank you for saying yes every time I ask you to come and share.
We're always here for you whenever you need us. Just let us know.
All right. So, Patrick, we'd like you to talk a little bit about the theme self-love. What can you say about that?
Most of our issues deal around not loving yourself. Most every issue, in some way or another, always comes back that you're just not loving yourself enough. And basically, it's kind of embedded in us to always look for love outside, look for guidance outside, and not really look inside the self, and not really love the self.
And how can you one love the self? Because most people just complain that it's so hard. It's much easier to seek for this love from outside, from other people. And what could you tell someone to find that love in themselves?
Yeah, I think they really need to realize is that when you're feeling love, like for instance, when you, let's just say you meet somebody and you love somebody outside, where's the source of this love? If you really feel it and connect to it, what they're doing is they're just activating the feeling of love inside of you. So you
Yes.
say, thank you. You've helped me activate this love inside myself.
Yes.
And it can be a person. Usually it happens a lot with people, but animals are great with this. You know, that's why some people like dogs and cats more than people. And other, working in a garden. As you love and appreciate working in the garden, that can also bring in more self-love because what's happening is that this external is being appreciated on the inside. And then of course you need to start with gratitude. Being grateful for being here, being grateful for being able to experience this world. And to be quite honest, I think there's a lot of people, especially in the spiritual path, who really do not want to be here.
Oh.
They want to leave. It's like, no, I'm from another planet. No, I'm from another lifetime. No, I'm from another galaxy. I'm not from here.
I've heard that a lot.
Yeah, you hear it a lot. And all of the above is true. You know, we are really not of this world. We're much more than this. But while we're here, we're here. So let's really appreciate why we're here now. And then all of this appreciation, all this gratitude comes back again to the self. It's very, very simple.
Yeah. I have a question from a subscriber of the channel.
Yes.
Her name is Benny Silva. She's 51 years old, and she says she is very submissive, and she's always seeking appreciation, approval, love.
Sure.
And she wants to be happy, and she wants to feel free. What's mm-hmm. what's your advice to her? What can she do to change this inner perspective?
Well, again, this all gets down to the self-love. If mm-hmm. you don't love yourself, then you look for it on the outside.
Mm-hmm.
And most of us tend to want to look to the outside, like we said. But we need to learn to appreciate ourselves more. And really through this, might say, inner work that we've been doing, and this is, again, a whole new, you might say, opening for us in terms of even mankind. This is new for it to happen on this level in this particular generation at this time. You know, I remember, you know, I'm old enough now to remember, you know, I could go into a bookstore and you would never see any books on metaphysics. You wouldn't see books mm-hmm. on meditation. I mean, I literally had to go to the National Library of Congress in Washington, D.C. to actually find certain books.
Wow.
And mm-hmm. and now you just get on Amazon, you can find any book you want. Anytime. Yeah. The information is all there for you. But, you know, when I was growing up, no, these information just wasn't available, readily available.
Yeah. And do you have any meditation you could teach to Benny to help her finding that love in herself and that appreciation in herself?
Well, of course. When I was in Sudan, I was taught a very beautiful meditation. It's very simple. Now, basically, it was a mantra, but it started out, you know, you would just repeat Allah. And as I would do that meditation, it turned into all love. So I would just repeat the words all love. And when I would do it, I would just feel in my heart and see if I could, you know, I'd say, just get that feeling of love in my heart when I would say it. Now, all of us know what it feels like when we fall in love. Okay?
Well, most people know.
Most people have had that experience at least once in their life. So it's like, what happens? You meet somebody, you really get attracted to them. And what happens in the heart center? It's like all of a sudden there's this like burning, warm sensation in the heart. All right?
Yes.
All because of this external stimulus.
Yes.
Now this is what we were saying before. This chemistry which is happening can happen without the external stimulus. And this is what a lot of people don't get. Now, once you have this experience where you just sit down and you just say, okay, I'm just gonna feel the love in my heart, just gonna focus on this love, keep focusing, pretty soon you'll start feeling this warmth in your heart. You go, oh, wow, well, I can actually do this, you know? It's a little bit like acting in the beginning. you know, okay, I'm just gonna pretend that I'm in love. I'll visualize somebody that I'm in love with. You can create this, and before you know it, all of a sudden you're feeling this sensation of love. Okay, now you can do that with any emotion. And in our class, we do this a lot of the times. For instance, I think it's very important just to be able to get yourself to feel on an emotional level. Just feel anything. Even hatred, even anger, sadness, happiness, you know. It's great. They have a thing called laughter yoga, you know.
Yeah.
And you just laugh, and you just laugh until you feel so good. And it's just like, you know, they, I remember they did a movie, Patch Adams, I think it was called.
Yeah.
Where they just did laughter therapy. And they found, hey, they could cure things with just laughing. So you can laugh, you can feel good, it releases endorphins in your body, you can imagine loving, really loving, and that releases it. Just the thought. Like, as soon as I say, think of somebody you love, the endorphins are released immediately in your body.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now what happens for some people though, is they feel this feeling of love, and then somehow or another that love gets broken. You know, the person mm-hmm. does something that they don't approve of.
Mm-hmm.
And then they say, okay, now I'm gonna not love you anymore, and they shut their heart. Mm-hmm. And then what happens? Well, then it feels like a little dagger's been put in your heart.
It hurts.
Okay. Yeah, it hurts really bad. Mm-hmm. And why? Because all of a sudden you're not getting that love from the outside. Now, if you can get that on the inside from something that's permanent, then you have it all the time.
Mm-hmm.
You know? So, like, if you can really connect with your soul body, your soul energy, you'll feel this love all the time. Some religions work in this way where, you know, love Jesus, okay? So you're working with something that's not in the physical plane, something on a spiritual plane that you can always love.
Mm-hmm.
And it can be Mary, it can be Jesus, it can be Kuan Yin, it can be an animal guide spirit, it could be anything.
Mm-hmm. Some saints that people have devotion to.
Yes, yes, yeah. It can. And in a long time ago, it used to be worshiping your ancestors, you know? Okay, mm-hmm. grandmother, I want to feel the grandmother spirit. And you remember the love that the grandmother used to give you. And that was, and especially in a few generations ago, the grandmother's love was so important because really grandmothers knew how to really give unconditional love to the mm-hmm. grandchildren. And some people have had that opportunity to experience that love.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So then they would, then you just think about grandmother, and all of a sudden you feel love in your heart.
You know, it happens to me when I am teaching. I feel in love with all the students.
Being in love with the camera, you know?
Yeah.
You find what brings love uh-huh. to you. And if teaching, sharing brings love, then great, because it's something you can always do for yourself.
Mm-hmm.
And most of this, even though I know you're helping 1 million people,
uh-huh.
congratulations.
Thanks.
Even though you're helping 1 million people, the person that you're helping the most when you're doing these videos is you.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
Yeah. Yeah, and it's like, do the job, do the work that brings joy to you. So in answering the question this lady asks, do you really love serving your husband? You know, do what you love doing.
Or serving other people, Because some people just feel like submissive to anybody, right?
Sure, yeah. Mm. And some people love doing that, and that's what they end up doing in their life. Mm. And it's perfectly acceptable. Now, sometimes there's certain programs out there now that say, oh, no, you shouldn't be doing that. But no, if it feels right to you, if you enjoy doing it, then do it.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
You know, it's just, this is just the way we are, the way we're wired.
Yeah.
And it's so lovely, you know, just do what you enjoy doing.
Então, uma surpresinha aqui no final do nosso vídeo. Eu quero falar com a Beni Silva, que ela nos enviou uma pergunta pelo nosso formulário de perguntas. E esse vídeo e essa entrevista, na verdade, foram inspirados na pergunta dela. E a Beni mandou o seguinte comentário no nosso formulário de perguntas. Estou vivendo um momento de muita reflexão interior e isso tem externado. Mas a percepção de algumas coisas me fez ver como eu ainda estava presa e como tenho aos poucos retomado a minha liberdade. Me ajude a perceber melhor o que é a subserviência e a aprovação. Espero que muitos como eu se libertem. Então, Beni, sobre a subserviência, né? O Patrick falou um pouquinho no final da entrevista, que eu perguntei para ele sobre submissão, na verdade, né? Mas eu entendo como, quando você fala sobre a necessidade de servir, né? Ser subserviente. Eu achei muito bacana que o Patrick levou essa pergunta para uma pergunta para a mente, né? E qual é o problema disso? Existem muitas pessoas que sentem a expansão do seu coração no ato de servir. E na verdade, eu acredito que muitas pessoas são assim. Eu sinto isso em mim mesma. Muitas vezes eu estou numa live com vocês, ou eu estou aqui diante de uma câmera produzindo um vídeo e eu, nesse momento, sinto o meu coração expandir. Eu até comentei isso com o Patrick, falei assim, pois é, eu também. Quando eu estou com os meus alunos, eu me sinto apaixonada por todos eles. E muitos são pessoas que eu nunca vi, como você que está me assistindo. A gente está aqui diante da câmera e eu sinto esse coração. Então, qual é o problema em a gente servir? A gente, quando serve, de fato, sente a expansão do coração. Porque tudo, todo o planeta, tudo o que existe nos serve. Existe uma meditação que eu gosto muito, que na verdade não é uma meditação, é uma percepção. É a gente perceber como tudo que está à nossa volta nos apoia. Preste atenção. O ar à sua volta te apoia, te sustenta. A força da gravidade te apoia. O assento onde você está sentado, o piso que você pisa, te sustenta. As paredes à sua volta, o teto sobre você, tudo isso te apoia. E se a gente for mais além, toda a natureza nos apoia. Tudo o que existe está aí nos apoiando, nos servindo. O universo nos serve. O que isso significa? Deus é este universo. Deus o tempo todo serve. E é por isso que quando a gente serve, a gente se sente feliz também, porque a gente se conecta com o serviço divino. E o nosso coração abre e o amor existe em nós. Mas a Beni fala assim, me fale, me ajude a entender sobre a subserviência e a aprovação. Porque muitas vezes a gente faz algo, a gente serve esperando a aprovação do outro. A gente espera que esse sentimento que a gente tem aqui venha de fora. Venha alguém dizendo, olha, você serviu bem. E então, esse reconhecimento, esta aprovação, nos ajuda a abrir o coração, vindo de fora. Aqui eu te peço que você se conecte com o que há dentro de você. Assim como disse o Patrick, esse amor que a gente imagina que vem de fora e ativa o nosso coração, na verdade já existe aqui. Então, no seu ato de servir, no seu ato de estar com as outras pessoas, eu não sei, aquilo que você faz com o seu companheiro, com filhos, com família, esse ato de estar com eles e às vezes servir, perceba que mesmo sem a aprovação, mesmo sem o reconhecimento, o coração abre. Mesmo sem esse incentivo que vem de fora, esse incentivo e essa inspiração estão aqui dentro. Então, Beni, sobre subserviência e aprovação. A aprovação, o reconhecimento do amor, está dentro de você. Não espere isso de ninguém e nem é necessário. Apenas se conecte, que você vai sentir que já está aí. E se você curtiu a nossa entrevista com o Patrick, se você quer conhecê-lo ainda melhor, eu vou deixar aqui o contato do Patrick para você saber sobre as aulas que ele dá, os workshops, nessa maravilhosa energia do All Love. Deixa para nós aqui um gostei no vídeo, deixa para mim o seu comentário e você pode me seguir também nas redes sociais. Um beijo!